ladies and gentlemen, and today I'm going to justify the fact as to why perfectly able individuals should be allowed to take the lift to the first floor. So now my context in what I'm arguing is, I'm not saying that people who live on the first floor should obviously take the lift every time, but what I am saying is that if they want to, they should have the right. So now my opponent here took a very amazing stance, and he might be a very amazing person that he believes whatever he said, but we need to draw a line between what he actually believes and what actually happens. So in light of the recent aggression that is going on against the people who take the first lift to the first floor, that is escalated, and that is the very reason why we are discussing on this topic in the first place. So now this argument that my opponent just promoted is like very shaky, because this is a basic belief that has been incorporated into the Ashokan community that people should not take the lift to the first floor. The behind it, what are the ethical values, that might be subjective, we don't know that, but this is a belief that has been incorporated. So what needs to be done is we should go to the root of the situation and analyze that how detrimental it is to the social structure of Ashoka as a whole. So now if a person is taking the lift to the first floor, then his purpose might be subjective. That person might be mentally tired, that person might not want to go to the floor, or he might have some personal reason. So that's the subjective. But what the other side takes is, it takes a policy of generalization when it is not considering the different scenario that goes on. So now if I give an argument of utility here, so basically if you prevent the people from taking the lift to the first floor, you decrease the utility. As a result, the collective utility of the society decreases. Now if some entitled human being comes and says to me, okay, listen, there are many people living on the top floors, so since they are more in number, their collective utility will decrease in compared to the first floor, then that argument doesn't stand valid, because of the very fact that if you are taking the lift for waiting for the lift for two to three seconds on the first floor, it is not irritating, but it is a social construct that has been promoted in your mind by some random individual who thought it would be very funny in the first place. So on the ground level, this isn't just a random situation which happened to random people on campus. This mostly happens to the people who live on the first floor. So this also takes the form of a kind of oppression that is being propagated against them. And it's a different building, not only first year, there are YFs and ASPs. So these are the people who are not only oppressed in terms of lift, they are also the people who are oppressed in other sectors, and this should be taken in mind. And what also intrigues the thought experiment is the process is that if seniors had been assigned the first floors, would this debate have happened on the first place? So this is like a carefully orchestrated form of structural oppression that goes here, and we have the white barrier that is being promoted. Now the entire crux of the moral ethics, what goes on and what doesn't, let us go on to the practicality of the situation of what actually happens in that. And if suppose we ban the people from taking it to the lift to the first floor, does it even lie in the view of the liberal arts principle of education? So this is like a very vague and ambiguous concept, and it's the social setting that exists and pre-existing within. It's a social construct that basically exists, and it is essential to understand that the argument against the people who take the lift to the first floor is completely futile, and we should try to live in a spirit of mutual coexistence. Thank you.